Hello and welcome to The Quint. I'm Ishartita Lahiri, and as a part of our election coverage from Mizoram, we have with us today the Chief Minister of Mizoram, Mr. Lal Thanawalas, who is now attempting for a record third term in office. The BJP is, for the first time, attempting to make a foray into Mizoram. Right. What would you have to say about their chances? What would you have to say about them?
Well, they have every right to try to open their account here. I'm nobody to say no to them, because every political party has the right to contest wherever they like, as and when elections are held. So elections are being held in Mizoram.
But do you think they have any chance?
I don't think so, unfortunately.
So you have said in the past that the MNF and the BJP are kind of holding back channel talks and are trying to tie up together. Right. Why do you think so? Why would you?
Because
you
see, there is a Northeast Democratic Alliance, which is initiated by the MNF. Hmm. By the BJP. And MNF is one of the members of this NEDA, Northeast Democratic Alliance. Hmm. So they have an alliance, they're working together. Hmm. Nobody can deny that.
But sir, as a counter to that, the MNF is in fact saying that, in a provincial election of the state. Mm. There was a time when the Congress and the BJP also joined hands. So
never.
now they are saying that they are together.
This is the first time this BJP is making their appearance in the assembly election arena.
Is the Congress party kind of wary of the fact that something like what happened in Meghalaya, something like what happened in Goa, where the BJP kind of used the post-election scenario and kind of what we in colloquial parlance would call horse trading, kind of engaged in that to form a government. Are you scared or are you wary that a situation like that could appear in Mizoram?
At least as far as my party, the Congress, is concerned, I'm not worried at all. But from other parties, if they are purchasable commodities, that I cannot say.
The opposition has made prohibition a very big issue this election. Mm. They say that Mizoram should go back to a place where there was prohibition on alcohol. What your party, of course, has brought about this change. Do you stick to your stance? What is your stance on the issue of alcohol prohibition?
It was I who imposed the total prohibition at the behest of the churches. But it was a total miserable failure. Mm. Because spurious liquor are available everywhere. The antisocial elements are making their presence felt. And rather than losing so many innocent lives, we thought that controlled lifting the total prohibition and allowing some people who wanted to sell liquor in a controlled manner.
But are you scared that this might alienate the church?
It is not the church matter. This is a social matter and this is administrative matter, quite different from the church activity. Mm-hmm. Now the church, at the behest of the church, we had tried. Mm-hmm. But it was a miserable failure. So we have to see, we have to cater to the need of all sections of the society.
A again, coming to the question of the bruise, like we saw that there was a huge issue that happened with the CEO of the Election Commission. What is the Congress Party's stance on the issue of bruise?
I was Chief Minister in 1977 when they left. I appealed to them not to leave because there was no need for them to leave. Those people who were, were not willing to leave, they were coerced into leaving Mizoram. Now, in spite of a big majority of them leaving this, the state, quite a good number of the population do not leave. They don't suffer anything at all, no discrimination, nothing at all whatsoever. And that official did not interfere at all with the election process. That fellow CEO, chief election officer, was, I think he despised the Mizo people, the way he was acting. And he was very communal also, the way he was acting. A junior officer did not respect at all his senior officer.
And we all know how rigorous the election process can be for anyone. One question, does it get easier from one time to the next time? Does going through the elections get easier? And at this age, how are you managing your campaigning and everything else?
It remains tough. Every election is the same. They remain tough, very tough. One has to campaign as far as possible. But in spite of my 80 years, I don't want to get old. I refuse to get old. I'm going to stay young and work as hard as when I was younger.